You are watching the Global Gamers Invitational Tournament brought to you by iFixit, SCVs for the real world, the Handsome Nerd attire for the handsomest of nerds, and Esports United, sponsored by Intel. This broadcast is also made possible by IC Cup TV, TeamLiquid.net, and of course, Blizzard Entertainment. Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Mac with another game from the Global Gamers Invitational Round of 32. This is Game 2 between Az and Chenji Sogood. Az showing in the previous game that it is still cool to proxy 2-gate a Terran player. It looks like he will not be doing that again given that he is not sending his probe already. And so since he's playing a more standard game, I can thank our sponsors in time. A huge thank you to iFixit, SCVs for the real world, but also Esports United and the Handsome Nerd, all donating prizes and cash to this tournament, bringing out the big names, and a very early scout coming here for Az. The pylon is in his base, however, so I don't suspect we'll be seeing anything proxy. It looks like he is, in fact, just checking for a counter proxy from this Terran player. This is a great map to place a proxy Reaper Barracks here. Very strong against Protoss, and given that he just quote-unquote cheesed his opponent last game, I would be concerned about counter cheese. I prefer to call it rushing, a counter rush, early harassment strategy, something like that. No barracks being built because Az is blocking it, and he will pull away here after damaging this SCV nicely. A barracks is going up. Not much of interest going on other players' bases. They're all playing completely standard builds, Az playing back from his ramp, because you don't want to choke yourself off by, that sounds horrible. You don't want to build a choke point that blocks you from getting at Terran ranged. You actually are building a choke point that your zealots can't engage if you build too many gateways at the front, so pulling them back is a sensible thing to do. Getting a standard assimilator, standard gateway, standard pylon, and his opponent, meanwhile, not getting to wall off, but he can always lift this up. I hear a probe died. I don't see it, but it looks like the scouting probe of Az is down, so he will no longer see the interior of his opponent's base, won't see that second early gas before the orbital command. I suspect we'll be seeing that as soon as this barracks lands. Orbital command right now? No, yes, it is. Good, orbital command coming, double gas. That smells a little bit like early siege tanks or banshees, so we'll have to see what he does with this, producing only that single marine and scouting with his SCV. Good time to scout too, because it's a standard Protoss build and worth seeing. Only one gas so far. Second one coming up at a very standard time. He's at 19. Just as he's getting the cybernetics core. And not producing a first zealot, probably saving up for immediate warp gate tech and a stalker to kick this SCV out of the Protoss base. And no, he's going to chrono boost the zealot first, probably realizing that he needs to build that stalker. Warp gate tech on the way. And probably going to see a Stalker right away after this. So I guess the Zealot here is just to intimidate the SCV before Stalker kills it. The Stalker is now on the way. The wall off now complete for Chenji, getting a reactor down for his barracks. A factory and another, it looks like a supply depot being built. So a factory and a barracks, maybe a siege tank marine push. That is fairly effective against Protoss. Probably not quite as solid as early Marauders, but still an option nonetheless. His opponent not going to know about that. He wasn't able to get a scout since the completion of the first barracks, and probably not going to get another one until the stalkers come out. So this SCV has gotten a very nice look around, but the stalker is going to be able to intercept this SCV easily and handily dispatch it. Good night, SCV. And Az now has firm control of his base, can now lay down more tech without his opponent detecting it, which usually means a whole whack of new gateways. Yes, there goes two more gateways, and this probe looked like he was thinking about it. Yes, he is throwing down a fourth gateway, so a four gate coming here from Az. His opponent just pumping marines and siege tanks and a starport, so this is a 1-1-1 build. Siege tanks really are the ticket, as it were. A few siege tanks right here will do a nice job delaying a four gate push. However, you can always harass the back door, and that is the problem with siege tanks early game against Protoss in a map like this. They just don't have the mobility to cope with a mobile 4-gate harassment force. Chenji not transitioning to anything new. We'll see what comes out of the starport. He's building a tech lab, which suggests banshees. He does have the gas for them, so I wouldn't be surprised if he does that. And it's lagging. And apparently I, too, get to experience this lag. I didn't know replays kept track of lag, but there it goes. That's probably just a total coincidence, but pretty cool nonetheless. And the back door, going to be harassed. There's that forward pylon, so Az is not even wasting his time with the front door. He's going to take them the back door, but he is busy talking and not killing these rocks. The four gateways are up, warping in stalkers inside his base because this pylon was not quite up yet, I guess. And he's now working on that back door. Chenji can hear it. He has a siege tank. He does not have the siege tech. However, he neglected the siege tech. He's building a Raven of all things. Raven probably for the projectiles of these stalkers, but no marauders, no siege tech. That's not what he needs to deal with a four gate at all. He needs that siege tech, and he needs it now. Front door now going to be pressured. A few stalkers here just take that back. He is going to keep working on the rocks with these stalkers, but I'm actually very concerned here for Chenji. He does not have the forces he needs. I don't know how this Raven is going to help him win against a four-gate push. He is defending the front door a little bit too much. Supply blocked at a very bad time. Still no siege tech. He needs that siege tech. That would stop this before it's too late. No bunker either. Clearly is just not aware of the trouble he's in. Very broke. That's part of the problem. But those Zealots are just going to walk right up here with sentry and stalker support. And this is going to be over before it begins. That is such a small army. He is beaten by 13 supply. Those Zealots do engage. First one going down, but they have the surround, and that is it. Those Marines trapped in force fields. This is the new release force fields. They can actually trap units inside them, which I think is stupid, but that's okay. Chenji now getting ready to rally for this last-ditch effort, but he threw those Marines away, didn't accomplish anything. Just not prepared for this four-gate whatsoever. Being royally outclassed here by Az. And this force is going to be eliminated just in time. Here is a Raven with no energy with which to cast anything. And he's definitely paying for the foolishness of building an early Raven. Chenji being dismantled here. His base is now as good as gone. More units being warped in, not reinforced, because Az definitely recognizes this game is over. He has taken the match and the series. Az will move on to the round of 16. Chenji will be playing golf for the rest of the summer. So short series, only about 15 minutes of playtime, Az winning both games handily and quickly. But efficiency is the mark of a skilled player, I guess. Well played by Az. So thanks for tuning in, guys. Keep following this tournament on TeamLiquid.net, but also on IC Cup TV. We are going to have 100% coverage from here on in. I imagine there are going to be some live streams of the final round of 16. This is the qualifying round of 16. There will be another round of 16. The final four will move on to the final tournament. So keep tuning in, guys. Tons of games coming. Huge names. Lots of good players. You will see some great games. So do follow this tournament. And until next time, have a good one.